Okay, let's take a quick look at this bias oscillator which I have in my tape echo effect. And this is a clap oscillator, which is a modified Kolbitz oscillator. I think the only difference is that there's some additional capacitors here somewhere. But if you want to calculate the frequency of oscillation, it's basically defined by this inductor and this capacitor, assuming that this capacitance here and this capacitance here is much larger than this one. So this is 20 times larger than this one, and this is 100 times larger than this one. So we can use the approximate formula, which gives with this setup 56 kilohertz, which is a good approximation with this one. I've marked here that it should be used ceramic capacitors, because I noticed that with some plastic capacitors there was some fluctuation in the oscillation, so they were not functioning very reliably. So I think the ceramic capacitors are much more reliable in this setup. That's what I found. And the transistor need to have some kind of current capacity, so it's, you cannot really use basic capacitors or transistors. You need to have something that can take a bit more watts than a normal transistor. So I have used this PC327 and PC337 transistors, which I think take about 0.6 watts of power. So I think they have lasted in this circuit quite well. The voltage at this point will be very large if it's not loaded by the record head. And this is a dual potentiometer in my pocket setup, but in my breadboard setup it's individual resistors, potentiometers. Okay, I think that's all for this schematic. I think I now will show the actual measurements in the oscilloscope. Okay. So here we have the oscilloscope. And the oh, it cannot be seen. Maybe here. So this is the whole tape echo circuit here in the breadboard, but in this corner we have the oscillator, and I've now separated so that it's not loaded by the tape head or the record amplifier. So it's just taking the voltage from the capacitor at the end of the other channel. So now I will just plug in an 9-volt battery in. So let's check what are the voltages. Okay, so it looks a very clean sine wave. I think there's some kind of distortion at this point, but for the naked eye it looks quite nice. And here we have a measurement of 58 kilohertz, so it's 2 kilohertz more than what the formula gives us, but that was only the approximate formula. And the mean root square voltage here is 43 volts, which is quite much when you consider that it's powered by a 9-volt battery. So peak-to-peak voltage is almost 130 volts. So I think this was quite amazing when I tested this circuit the first time. So I was quite amazed. But this is the unloaded situation. And if we adjust it from the resistor potentiometer, we can only adjust it down to 35 volts of root mean square voltage. So there's about 8 volts of adjustment at this point. So let's see now when we connect the tape head. Should be connected now. So what do we have? What? Okay. I don't think this is right. It's more. So we have 52. Okay, I didn't even measure this previously. Interesting. Is that okay? Maybe I'm measuring from the wrong point. So maybe we are interested on the actual voltage which the tape head is getting. So let's see. Is that the same? No, it's the same. Okay, fine. Interesting. Okay, next we will check when we connect. Well, maybe take this off. Then we connect the record amplifier also with the series resistor. It comes here. Then this should be at maximum. Okay, so let's see now what we get. Okay, so now it's reasonable. So, okay, when the record amplifier is connected, we get this down to about 20 volts root mean square. And well, the peak-to-peak voltage is still almost 60 volts. And now that we can adjust this, the range is now much more that we can actually adjust with the potentiometer. So it goes down to 1.6 volts of root mean square voltage. And when we put it to maximum, it's that almost 20 volts of root mean square. And actually, when using at least the chrome tapes, we need to have it almost in the maximum so that we can bias the tape correctly in the somehow linear region. But there still, I think I noticed that there's some distortion and things like that. So I don't know how much does it actually require. It also depends on what is the inductance of this tape head, so how much it can actually drive the tape. So. But in my setup, I think this has been very suitable. So you can really actually notice that if you put it to the maximum, the volume level starts dropping in the recording. So it's basically going over biased at this point. So maybe the optimal would be somewhere around 15 volts of root mean square to bias tape, but then it's kind of there's still some distortion noticeable in the recording, but it's, well, maybe it's like what you can expect with tape recording, but in all, I think this is very interesting to make this kind of circuit to bias the tape, so. Which I didn't actually even know before, that the tape needs to be biased, that you can actually record on that. But anyway, I think this is all for the oscillator part, so maybe something else covered in the next video.